first one is the lat pull down. I'm doing it with one hand, one arm. And as anybody may know, you have one side that is stronger than the other. So sometimes I like to do one side at a time. And I think I did 20 each, but 10 on the first side and 10 on the other side. And then I alternate them, giving each side a little bit of rest. So I'm pulling with my back muscle. The initial pull is done with, the back muscle. And by the end, I guess, once that muscle cannot do any more pulling, but there's still more room to pull, I will allow my arm or whatever muscle that is capable of doing that extra pull, I will do it. But the initial pull is done with the back muscle. As you can see, it's like the rotator cuff area muscles that doing the majority of the pulling. You can see some of the muscles being stretched and contract. And that's very important in doing exercise, is the stretching and the pulling. Stretch and pull. You pull as much as you can with the muscle you're trying to target, and make sure you do that extra stretch to allow the muscle to stretch and contract. So I think this is the last one for each arm. And I'm going to switch the grip to wide grip. And it's one thing everybody should do, take as little rest as possible before you start doing your exercise. Gather all the stuff you know you're going to need so you don't have to walk around the gym. So I had all the stuff that I'm going to use. I put it close by, and the minute I finish with what I needed, and I switch over. I mean, sometimes you can't really do that because when the gym is packed, people need to use some of the equipment. But when it's empty like that, as you can see, there's not that many people. It's good to have all the stuff you're going to use close by. And right now, this is a wide grip. And again, the initial pull is done with the back muscle. And once the bar passes my chin area, I can't do any more pulling with the back muscle. I allowed my arm to do that extra pull or finalize the pull. And now I switch the angle. I'm about maybe 180 degrees or so, 130 degrees or so, and not 130. And as you know, muscle fibers don't run, in one direction. They all spread out. So I try to switch my angles to hit as many fibers as I can. I mean, some muscles will be hit twice or more, but it's good to switch your angle. And I think for the single arm, I did, 30 pounds. And then for the right grip, I think I did 60 or 70. And for the close grip, and I think I did either 80 or 90. I don't think it was that much. But I usually do more with close grip. For some reason, I'm able to do more. So again, it's the same concept. You do the stretching and the pulling. And you have to allow the muscle to do the pulling. And once it's, all the way up, you let the muscle stretch. And I think that's all I did on the pull down. And that day I didn't really want to do that much. I really had no motivation to be at the gym, but I wanted to go and just do something. And while I was at the treadmill warming up, and I said, let me do one set of everything. Usually on Saturdays I do full body exercise, but that day I was not feeling it at all. So the only thing that I decided to do was to do one set of everything. But this, I did two set of this one actually, because the first, luckily I looked at the video and all I saw was my butt. So I decided to do another set to record. again, I did one set. I think I did 20 for each side, and but 10 first, and then switch the other arm, do another 10, and then go back and forth on it until I did 20. So, you know, that allows the muscles to do some of the work. When you have one side that is stronger than the other, and when both are doing the exercise, one of them will be lagging, will allow the stronger side to do most of the work. So to make sure both sides is actually doing the work, that's what I do. I do one at a time, and then I'll do two, use both hands. And again, I'm doing the pulling with my back, upper back, and if there's more range that needs to be completed, then I will allow my arm to do that extra pull. And I think I only did one, 10 of this, and that's it for this. I didn't do three sets or anything like that. I ended up doing two sets because the first one, then I didn't record it very well. This actually was the first one that I did once I got off the treadmill. This is cable crossover. I think I did either 20 or... No, it's not 20 reps. I think I did 14 reps on this. I did as much as I can. And normally when I focus on my back, when it's back day only, I'll do 7 sets with, 12 reps. So this time I only did 1 set and 14 reps. You know, I did as much as I can. If I could go more, I would have done more. But I ended up doing only either 14 or 16. I think it was 14 though. And here, I'm switching the height of the pulley. And I think, I don't know what it calls, but this exercise, I decided to do it one day and it felt really good. And calling it bent over pull. It's good for the chest and it's good for the back. But like I said, I like to do one side at a time. And it's not all the time I do this, actually. This is to help, you know, how do you call it? Rotator cuff muscle. That's the shoulder muscle. And that was the first one, the second exercise that I did after I did the cable crossover. So this one is good for the chest and it's good for the back. And a lot, sometimes I do it with both hands at the time, but today I just wanted to do one at a time because I know I was just going to do one set. So I wanted to make sure the muscles that I'm trying to target actually doing the work. And I switched the other hand, the other side. And as you can see, I'm not really going really too heavy. I think it was only 12 pounds. So that's what I'm doing here. And one thing people have to realize when you do an exercise, it depends on your goal. If you're trying to do for strength, then, you know, obviously the weight is going to be matter. You know, you increase your weight as you, the weight as you progress. But if you're trying to look aesthetic and trying to, you know, improve your, the way your body looks, really the weight does not matter. You just have to make sure the muscles you're trying to target is being hit. You know, you make sure that muscle does the work. And here's the reverse fly. And this, I did, right now the seat is at, I think the level is 4 or 5. And I did 20 reps of this. And then I moved the seat a little bit higher to the next level. And I did another 20. And then I move it to the last level, and I did another 20. So I ended up doing 60 repetition of this with no break. The only break was to move the seat. And I don't normally do it like this. Again, like I said, I did not want to be at the gym today. So that was one thing I did in order for me to make sure that I hit the muscles that I'm trying to target. And this exercise, the way that I'm doing it, by lowering the seat level, I don't recommend it for anybody to do, because you could easily dislocate your shoulder. So you have to know, you know, your range of motion, how much you can actually handle. So I know I could handle that, so I lower it to as low as I can, and then move it up a little bit until I, you know, I finish the exercise. Again, I think that will be the last rep, and then I'm gonna do another 20 repetition of this. And the weight, I think it was either 40 or 45. It wasn't that heavy, because I know I was gonna do a lot of repetition, so I didn't put it too heavy. If I put it, let's say 70, there's no way I could do that much. So right now, I think it was at 40, either 40 or, yeah, I think it was 40. So here I'm pulling with the back muscle, and once I reach a different, you know, range, and I allow my my arm to do that extra pull, push to the back. And I'm done with this. As a matter of fact, I cut the video here, but I did the same thing for the chest also. But since this video is for back, I just cut it just to show the back area. And I'm gonna do another video putting everything. And here I switch over, and I'm doing, normally when I do, when I focus on back, when it's back day, I'll do the reverse fly, the exercise that I just did, and then right away I move to this, because they're close by. It's not like I have to walk all around the gym to get to it. It's right next to each other, and I will go, I'll do maybe 12 reps of the reverse fly, and then I'll jump into this and do another 12, and then back and forth until I do whatever set that I wanted to do. So this one is really good for the back. And one thing that I did here, I lowered the seat as much as I can, so when the handle is high, I'm able to reach. So that will allow the muscle to stretch. So the stretching is very important. And this one is the last exercise that I have on this video. But I did other thing that day, but there were a lot of people there I didn't record. That mean I will have to edit it and make sure I black people's face and all this stuff. So too much, so I decided not even to record it. So this thing is almost the same as the last one that I did. This one, I think it's called a pull down. I lower the sit as much as I can, and that way when the handle is high, I'm able to do that extra stretch. And right now it's a little bit of a wide grip, not really, but that's where the handles are. And once I'm done with this grip, I change to close grip. And I think the weight was 70. I don't remember exact. I think it was 70 pounds. And again, I'm pulling with the back. As you can see, some of the back muscles is stretching and contracting. So the stretching and the contracting is very important. And that's it for this video. I hope you guys like it. Please subscribe. And this was my first voiceover, and I hope you guys like it. Thanks.